People always say, what was the best fight of your career? I say Ricky Hatton. I said, I loved it. Wasn't my best performance, but it was my best fight. I loved Ben in that fight. 12 rounds, we had a war. Best man won, but I tell you what, I pushed him to the wire. We were both cut, you know.
Bloody war.
We had an absolute war. And people, it's funny, people still come up to me now and talk to me about that fight. 18 years later, you know, people still come up and say, what about the Hatton fight? You know, and you know, I feel very proud and privileged, you know, that I shared a ring with him, you know. The best man won, and people still remember it.
Did you know at that point that Ricky was going to go on to do what he did?
Yes, definitely. You know, he had a bad cut in the first round. I thought I'd won the lottery, you know. But he went on, and even if I'd have beat him on a cut, you know, what wouldn't have been a great win. I know we'd had a rematch and he'd have beat me that year, but just put the record straight. He's a class fighter throughout his career, from early on, right the way through.
Mm-hmm. Because you won that, I said world champion, the WBF.
Yeah, I won a WBF title, you know. Yeah, I won it. It may do at the time, but you know, being champion of Britain, that was what I was proud of. Yeah. Being champion of Europe, yep, second attempt. Got beat by Romanov, then I beat Juan Carlos Diaz Melro, whatever, for the title about 6 months to the day later.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you had some sort of ruining that Lonsdale belt was a. Real highlight.
That was the highlight of my career.
Yeah.
Beating Lee Meagher on points. That was my best performance. Mm. Best performance. And going in there as a big underdog, everyone ripped me off. But as I told everyone, one thing in life you can't buy is experience. Oh, Lee Meagher had the talent, the youth, but I had the experience, mm-hmm. and that's what got me through. And I boxed a perfect fight that night.
You've been in with, like we said, Hatton there, some big names, and the European stage as well, some of the top fighters of the day, and you know, through it was, what was the toughest fight you had, John?
We've been talking about this on the way up here and all today, Eamon McGee. Mm-hmm. I want to beat him with forehands. His trainer's here today, and we were speaking about it, and he told me I was the only fighter he ever trained for. Everyone else, he didn't bother training. He was just a very naturally great fighter. But for some reason, he decided to train for me. Well, it's a bit unlucky for me, but there you go. I want to beat him with forehands.
Mm-hmm. He used to have a cig, didn't he, before fights outside? He's renowned for that. Eamon McGee, he'd have a cig outside.
Yeah, or a pint, whatever, and then go
box. He gave up for you for a bit.
Yeah, typical, innit? But there you go. Yeah.